Hello everybody and welcome. It's been a while, I've grown a bit of a beard, and today we're going to talk about something very, very interesting. Today's discussion is free will. Is it actually a thing, and how do you find out more about it? So today I'm not actually going to explain any particular topic. I'm going to explain to you, or I'm going to present to you a perspective, a point of view. So here's my perspective on free will. Is it a thing? So let's analyze this. In this world, we are all physical beings, like we have atoms in our body. Everything in this world is made up of atoms, right? And let's think of this. A meteor or a comet is a bunch of atoms, and it is hurtling through space, going through whatever path it's going to take. And this path is determined by the gravitational forces which influences this object in space, correct? And say, for example, if a comet is approaching the sun, the solar winds affect the comet and a huge tail comes out. Depends, a huge tail or a small tail or whatever it is. And you can say that a comet has no particular control over its path, right? Why do you say this? Why do you say that the comet has no particular control over its path? It's very simple. We know that the comet has no particular mind of its own, right? But we do. We have a mind of our own, right? But if you remove that part of the, if you remove mind, what are we left with? We are also a bunch of atoms, just like any other object in space, any other object in this entire universe, we are a bunch of atoms, right? And we are on this planet, so our body is made up of the same atoms that were present on Earth from I don't know how many millions and how many billions of years, right? So our atoms are moving through space and time in a particular way. Now, if you consider a comet or a meteor, our mathematics is advanced enough now that we can calculate the future trajectory of a comet and also the past trajectory of a comet, right? We know, we can predict where it has come from. Why? Because it obeys certain laws. That's it. It's very simple. Now, if you put the same analogy to us, we are also a bunch of atoms, just like a comet or a meteor. What is to say that we have any control over what we are doing right now? This video, you and I, so you are watching and I'm making, who is to say that this is of my own free will, right? So I've not made a new video for the last, like, what, 2 months? And who is to say it was a choice? How do you know it was any choice or any free will, that you didn't make up your mind to do a video, or you didn't make up your mind to do anything, any particular thing? Think about this. I really want you to think about this and leave your opinion in the comments below. This gets very, very deep, and we're going to be analyzing this particular approach in the next few videos, and we'll see how this goes. Right? So think about this. If a bunch of atoms has a mind, then it suddenly develops a free will. Is that what we are saying? So the mind is giving you the ability to choose whether to do things or to not do things. Is that willpower? I want you to really spend time thinking on this particular issue, whether you actually have free will or not. Now comes the question of, if you're going to start commenting about destiny and all these things, please don't do that. Just give your opinion on whether you have free will or not. Whether is there such a thing as free will or not? Is there such a thing as choice or not? Whether you, on a daily basis, whether you are choosing to do certain things, or whether it is the property of the atoms within your body to execute those things just by default. How do you know whether a rock has a mind or not? How do you know whether the comet or the meteor has a mind or not? We're going to be getting into these things later on, but think about all these things, okay? So very simple, free will. Now if you analyze your body as a bunch of atoms, it seems like there is no such thing as free will. It seems like there is no such thing as choice. Like, it's like the ocean's waves or any of these things, right? Does it have a choice, or is it influenced by certain other events happening around it, and this event also occurs? It's as simple as that. Think about this and leave your opinion in the comments below, and we'll see where this goes. All right. So this was quite a short video, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye bye. Also, a quick note, I forgot to add this in the previous segment. A quick note, if you like exploring these things, if you like exploring your mind, if you like exploring your body and figuring out the mysteries of the universe, understanding and unraveling these things, which are amazing secrets of yoga, please visit the website that I've mentioned in the description, chamundigurukulam.in. This is where you get the opportunity to learn these amazing stuff, and this will greatly help you in your life, take you on this amazing spiritual path. If you want to start that journey, visit the website mentioned in the description below, chamundigurukulam.in. Okay, take care. Bye bye.